Welcome back, Grade 7 students, to our Arts Quarter 1, Module 5, Creation of Arts and Crafts of Luzon, Highlands and Lowlands, Attire, Fabrics, and Tapestries. This module will guide you to analyze the elements and principle of arts that can be observed in the designs of the attire, fabrics, and tapestries from Luzon. For learners' objectives in this module, learners will be able to determine the different materials and techniques used in attire, fabrics, and tapestries production in the Highlands and Lowlands of Luzon. Make or create attire, fabrics, and tapestries using local materials and techniques. And appreciate the weaving techniques of Luzon by determining the proper use of elements and principles of art and how it reflects their culture. For your first activity, based on the discussion in the previous module, describe the identity used in the following textile. For the second column, write a description and uses of saya, kain, lufid, kadangyan, bakwat, and ginaspala. For the third column, write the techniques used. And for the fourth column, write the materials used in saya, kain, lufid, kadangyan, bakwat, and ginaspala veins. Answer the following follow-up questions. Number 1, how were you able to describe each textile? Number 2, what clues helped you to describe the textile? Number 3, what tribe or group usually utilizes it? And number 4, was it easy for you to identify and describe each textile? Why or why not? In our past lesson, you learned about the elements and principle of arts present in the arts and crafts of Luzon, Highlands and Lowlands. Let's make a review before we proceed to our next lesson. The ingredients for great composition of masterpiece are the elements of arts. The first element, which is considered the most important among the elements, is line. It is a mark produced by a tool like pencil, pen, or paintbrush as it moves across a paper or surface. Line can be characterized as long or short, thick or thin, oblique and diagonal, horizontal or vertical, broken or solid, waving or zigzag, straight or curved. Another element which created when a line becomes connected and encloses a space is called shape. There are two types of shapes, the geometric and organic shapes. Geometric shapes are measurable like square, circle, triangle, and rectangle, while organic shapes have more complicated edges like leaves, stones, flower, and etc. Next is formed. It has three-dimensional object. It has height, width, and depth, and not flat like shapes. Its depth shows the thickness of the object. Color add interest to artwork and make it more realistic. When light is reflected through a prism, color can be seen. These colors are red, yellow, orange, green, indigo, blue, and violet. Blue, red, and yellow are said to be primary because they can't be mixed to be made, and they make all the other colors on the color wheel. When you mix two primary colors together, you get a secondary color. The fifth element is value. It's the lightness or darkness of a color and makes object more real because it imitates natural light. Light source is needed when showing value in a work of art. How the surface of an object actually feels is called texture. In the artistic world, we refer to two types of texture, the tactile and implied. Tactile or real is the way the surface of an object actually feels, like a texture of sandpaper, cotton balls, tree bark, puppy fur, and like. Implied texture is the way of artists that is used when they draw and paint objects, and this object portrayed look like as it feels in person. It may look rough, fuzzy, gritty, or scrappy, but it can't actually be felt. The last element that refers to the distance around, between, above, below, and within an object is called space. There are two types of space, the positive and negative. Positive space is the space used or the space where the object is placed. Negative space is the unused space. Principle of arts are tools to make elements of art organized. The first principle is balance. It is the arrangement of the elements or objects to create a feeling of stability in a work. Its forms include symmetrical, asymmetrical, and radial balance. Rhythm and movement are the regular repetition or duplication of elements to produce the look and feel of movement, while pattern is the repetition of design. When one area or thing stands out the most or serves as the focal point of an image, it is called the emphasis. Another principle that shows large difference between two things to create interest and tension is contrast. Proportion comes when there is a comparative relationship of one part to another with respect to size, quantity, or degree, or scale. Variety refers to the changes and difference of the elements used to the work and thus increase visual interest. Unity is obtained when all the elements and principles are placed, organized, and work together to create a pleasing image. After reviewing the elements and principle of arts, let us see how it applies to the arts and crafts of Luzon. In the Philippines, textile have unique designs, characteristic materials, function, and uses. The process of making their textiles, tapestries, attires, and fabrics is called weaving. It is a tradition that dates back several centuries and is an intrinsic part of Filipino culture. Our ancestors make their own design using their knowledge and techniques in making textiles and fabrics. It is important for them to preserve their traditional styles in creating the said crafts. Highlands and lowlands of Luzon are rich in fabric or textiles, attires, and tapestries. Fabric or textile is a cloth produced by weaving, knitting, taffing, knotting, and banding together using natural or synthetic threads, yarns, and other materials. Attire refers to the clothes or outfits worn by a group of people in a specific area or community. Tapestry corresponds to any piece of decorative fabric to where the designs were originally applied through weaving as the fabric is being made. It is used to cover furniture or floors, hang on walls, or clothing decorations. There are proper and unique techniques in weaving of raw materials used in highlands and lowlands of Luzon. Textile or fabric of Ilocos Region. Inabel fabric is made of cotton and well-known for its softness, beautiful designs, and strength. Ilocanos use the wooden or pedal loom or what they called pangablan, applied through several weaving technique and features different designs or patterns. One of their techniques is the double-tone basket weave or distinct binakol weave that represents the sea waves. They believe that it protects the one wearing it from evil spirits. Another technique is the suksuk or discontinuous supplementary weft technique. Among the complicated ones is the brocade weave or pinilian, which uses a stick inserted in selected rope threads to create designs that floats in the threads. There are two kinds of pinilian, scattered and continuous supplementary weave techniques. The weavers of Pinili Ilocos Norte are said to be adept in the simultaneous warp and weave float type of pinilian called the impalagto, a technique unique in the town. These patterns depict different landforms, colors of flowers and vegetation, paved zigzags, animal patterns, ocean waves, glittering night sky, and the like. These are the designs inspired by natural elements that can be seen in their textiles. Are from Ilocos Region, kimona and pandiling. The traditional Ilocano dress made from inabel came in a two-piece ensemble, blouse and skirt. The blouse, called kimona, is either plain white or pastel, usually with a cowl neckline. A full-length skirt, called pandiling, is cone-shaped with a drawstring around the waist. The design in the weave are inspired by things in nature such as diamonds, Milky Way, shells, and stripe or checkered. The dress is worn over a full sleeve called camison. The chinelas, meanwhile, is a pair everyday footwear made of leather, while the formal footwear called kutso are made of beaded felt and leather which are worn on Sundays and fiestas. Ilocos Region tapestries. A hand-woven wrap around cloth called tapis is a rectangular-shaped, vibrantly colored cotton fabric traditionally worn by Ilocanos. It serves as clothing decoration that complements to the pandiling. Another tapestry from Ilocos Region is their blankets. The wasik blankets with striped design are 100% originally hand-woven by the artistic weavers of Bangar, La Union. They use a bell weaving practice in a two-petal traditional wooden loom. Each blanket is literally a work of art which continuously preserves the beauty and usefulness of itself for years. Cordillera Administrative Region. Textile and fabric of Kalinga. The natives of Kalinga are skilled in terms of weaving. They exhibit motifs as thought as they embedded in the geometry itself. the upper Kalinga weavers put textures in the stripe bands using a twill weave technique. This technique is made when the weft thread passes over two or more warp threads and repeats the design one warp thread over so that a diagonal or oblique line is formed. Some characteristic of Kalinga textile are tiny motifs, pattern, and embellishment, including miniature lattice, continuous lozenge pattern, locally called inata-ata, and pawikan or mother-of-pearl platelets, among others. The color used in the textile have cultural meanings. Red signifies bravery, black is for the soil or land, white is for the flower and coffee trees, yellow for the sand, and green for the mountains. Kalinga attire. The attire of male Kalingas is the bag, or commonly called bahag. It is long textile or fabric measuring about 10 to 15 inches wide and 3 to 5 feet long. It is used for cover their private parts and is firmly secured at the waist to prevent the cloth from falling off. Some of them include their costume, a headgear with feathers, and some armbands. Kalinga tapestries. Southern Kalinga women wear a tapis called kain, a large rectangular woven clothing about 3 to 5 feet wide and 3 to 4 feet long. It is worn below the abdomen and reaches below the knee. Meanwhile, the cotton blanket called kagoy came from Malbakan. It is large rectangular blanket made of three stripes of material sewn together. It consists of color white cloth with red, yellow, and green stripes. Bontok textile or fabric. It consists of Bontok color white people cloth are skilled red, weavers too. Yellow and green Their stripes. Weaving method is called ikat. Process of tying and dyeing the threads to prepare the patterns before they are woven into textile. The key factor in their life is seen on their textile design that revolves around the idea of centeredness, which symbolizes permanence, order, and balance. Bontok young girls usually start their training with the simplest part of the cloth, the langkit or edging. Next, they move on to paikid. Side panels, leaning to simple designs such as fatawil, wrap bands, and shokyong arrows. After mastering this level, they move on the most challenging part, the sinangadam design, which represents the sinamawaki weaving. Next is bontok attire. Bahag or wains is the traditional attire of men in bontok. It is made from long strips of hand-woven loincloth. The women wear a short and lufid, a narrow wrap-around skirt which covers the navel down to the knees and has a side opening. Bontok tapestries. Bontok and Kankanay women in Northern Cordillera people wears a type of belt called Gedaspala wains once they get married. It is decorated with continuous zigzag patterns woven in double face with braided warps that end as tassels. Cagayan Valley. Nueva Vizcaya textile and fabrics. Gadang textile in Nueva Vizcaya are usually decorated with little seed beads. They also use the twill weave technique because they are located near Ifugao, Benguet, and Quirino. Their textile are very symbolic, from plain to intricate floating warps, eye designs, and beautiful colorful twills. These textiles are woven by the women from homegrown cotton and dyed in bright natural colors. Nueva Vizcaya attire. The attire of Gadang women is long sleeve, round neck, colorless, and waist-length blouse. The upper colorless, short garment is also worn, together with headkerchief. They have lavishly tasseled and beaded headbands and comb. The traditional costume for Gadang male is the G-string, which is held in the girdle whose flap is weighted on the hem by headed tassels. Nueva Vizcaya tapestries. Another work of art of Gadang women is tapis or skirt. It is lengthy piece of cotton cloth worn around the waistline down to the knees. Bakwat is a cloth that serves as belt by the mother after giving birth. The center part of this cloth is commonly decorated with white beads accent embellished in patterns which represent rivers and mountains. Before we continue, let's see how well you understood the discussion. For activity 2, list down the materials and technique in making fabric, attire, tapestries given in the first column. On the second column, write all the materials used. And the third column, write all the techniques used. Activity 3. In this activity, you are tasked to choose two among the four textiles as presented below. After you choose, use the given diagram to explain their similarities and difference. Afterwards, respond on the following questions. Number 1. Based on your answer on the given diagram, how would you discuss the elements used in the artwork you have chosen? Number 2. Why did you choose the two textiles? What do you think are the elements that is made the two textiles similar and different? Please discuss. And for your assessment, the first part is multiple choice. Choose the best answer from the given choices. Write the letter of the correct answer on the space provided before each number. And the second part is matching type. Match the statement in column A with its corresponding answer in column B. Write the letter of the correct answer on the space provided before each number. Congratulations! You have reached the end of Arts Quarter 1 Module 5. You are now ready for the next module. Do not forget to click turn in your file in Google Classroom once you're done answering all the activities. Thank you and happy learning!